Hello friends, welcome to this video. In this video, we will learn how to process an RGB mask into a single channel mask for multi-class segmentation. To learn more about it, make sure that you watch the complete video and subscribe the channel. So, without any further delay, let's start the video. So here we are in our Atom Text Editor and we have our Python file here. So first of all, we are going to import all the required libraries. Okay, so here we have imported operating system numpy, cv2, pandas, glob and tqdm. The operating system is for the path, numpy is for the arrays, cv2 is for the reading and writing images, pandas is of no use, it's by mistake. Glob is used to extract the images and mask path, and tqdm is basically a progress bar. So these are all our libraries which we required. So first of all, we start with our main function here. Okay, so this is our main function. So first of all, we go with the data set. Let me show you the data set. It's a simple 5 images. Okay, so I picked these images from the Vogue 2012 data set. Okay, you can see these 5 images, and for these 5 images I have those RGB mask. So now the question is how to convert these RGB mask into proper format so that we can use them during multi-class segmentation. Okay, so we're going to convert these 5 mask into a proper format so that we can use them during multi-class segmentation. So this is the data. Now we're going to import that data set. First of all, we're going to say data set path, which is the data set term itself. Okay, now we need to import all the images. So we're going to say glob os dot path dot join. First is the data set path. This is the basically the main path. Second, inside it we have image folder, and inside that we require all the images with the JPG extension, and like this we would extract the mask path. And instead of images we need to write mask here, and here the mask are in PNG format. Okay, so we have images and mask. Now we're gonna print their length and check if we have the appropriate number of images and RGB mask. So let's run this program, and its name is RGB. Okay, so you can see images, their length is 5, and mask, their length is 5. So we have total number of 5 images and mask pair. Okay, so this much it is done. Now let's create some basic functions first. So here I'm going to create a function, or basically copy paste from my existing code. So this function called create dir basically takes a path. It checks if it exists or not. If it does not exist, then create that path. Okay, so first, because we need to save those grayscale or single channel mask also, so we're going to create a directory, and I don't want to make that the directory should be created by user. It should be done automatically. So this is for the dataset. Okay, I'm sorry for those comments. Okay, so first we need to create a directory. So we're going to say create a directory. Okay, now we're going to call the function create dir, and inside it we're going to say, let's call it mask. Okay, simple mask. You can write whatever name you want, it's not an issue, because we are using the Vogue 2012 data set. So I'm gonna import some things which I already defined. So this is basically the color map. Okay, and these are the Vogue classes. So it contains basically 20 classes. So color map is basically defined because in RGB we have 3 channels. So these 3 pixel values, basically 0, 0 and 0, is for the RGB. This first value is for R, the red channel. This is for green, and then last one is for blue channel. So basically this Vogue color map list contain list itself basically. So these lists are basically the pixel values, okay, for those RGBs. So it indicate if these pixels, if these are the pixel values for the RGB channel, then it would refer to background. So each of these pixel value refer to a specific class. So it is important that you have a proper color map. Okay, if there's any issue or mistake in color map, then it would be directly reflected into the mask, okay, and it would affect your performance while segmentation, because this would not, it would not match while you will calculate the loss. Okay, so make sure that this thing is okay. Okay, now we're gonna print it. These work classes and color map. Okay, it's an error, and I know why it is. Okay, so you can see. First, we have the class name, and then we have its respective pixel value. So these are 20 classes. First is background, then we have aeroplane, bicycle, bird, boat, bottle, and etc. etc. till TV monitor. So you can see a whole range of classes is there. So next, we're gonna loop over the images and mask. Okay, let's loop over. Loop over the images. Should not be image. It is images. Okay. So we're gonna say x comma y in zip. Okay. So we have two variables: images and masks. Now around it, we're gonna write TQDM. So we basically gonna wrap TQDM around the zip, and after the zip, we're gonna say total equals to length of images. So TQDM is basically progress bar. It tells us that something is happening, and let me just show you. Just comment it, and I'll show you what TQDM does. Okay, so you can see it basically shows this progress. It's so much fast that it haven't taken any second. Okay, it's literally very fast. It basically processes one by one. So it shows that out of five images, one is done, then second is done, until then. So you would see a beautiful progress happening. Okay, so now. So x and y are basically path. Let me just show you x and y, what x and y are. Okay, you can see x and y, this is the x path and this is y. So x refer to image and y refer to mask. Okay, now you can see these are not in proper sequence. If you see, first is 129, then 129 is it. So what we can do here, this is really one of the common mistake which I have made here and also make while I write the codes. We can say we can sort them. Okay, we write sorted here, and same for the globe. Now we're gonna see. Now you can see we have the same image name and the same mask name. Okay, now we need to extract this image name or this name, because we need to save the mask also, so we need the same name. Okay, let's do it. So we're gonna say call it name. And we're gonna split the x dot split on the base of slash. If you see, it has slashes, so we're gonna split it on the base of slash, and we would see a list. Let's print this name. Let's just break this loop here. Okay, so we can see a list. First term is data set, then image, and then 2017, the name of the image basically. So we need to extract this last element. So we're gonna say -1. Then again, you can either use this completely, or if you want to change the extension also, like you want to save it in JPG or any other format, you can even split it out on the base of dot. Okay, now see, now this last element itself is splitted into two items. First is the name, then second is the extension. Now we need to extract the name, which is on the zeroth index. Okay, so now we have the name. Okay, so this is done. We have extracted the name. Now let's read the image. Okay, so these both an image and mask are RGB image, three channel image. So we're going to read them as RGB format. Next, we are going to resize them. Okay, so we have resized them to a size of 320 by 320. Now let's create a function. Okay, which is going to process the mask. Basically, mask is the thing we need to work upon. Image is not the thing here. So let's say process mask, and what you take is the mask and the woke color map. Okay, classes doesn't matter, it's just for your visualization that this specific pixel refer to this class. Just make sure that this color map is always correct. Okay, if this has any issue, then there would be definitely issue in your mask, and I cannot confirm that this is like correct. I just copied it from somewhere, so maybe I have some mistake I tried. So you can just check it out from a side if this color map is correct or not. Okay, we will also see during the processing. So let's say it returns some mask, and we call it processed mask. So, okay, so let's go above and create a function process mask, and what it take is RGB mask, and second is take is it take is color map. Okay, so now we're gonna write some lines of code. First is the output mask. We're gonna create a list. We're gonna call it output mask. So what this function take is individual mask. It take one mask and the color map. So this color map it take, and it give you an mask. It would give you an array basically, and the shape of the array would be the height and width would remain the same as the mask, but the number of channel would be equal to number of classes. So if here if the mask contain 20 classes, so the output format here would be height by width by 21. Okay, so let's process it now. Let's create a loop here. I over color in enumerate, you're gonna enumerate over the color map. Okay, now in I we have an index starting from 0, and in color we have individual pixels. So we're gonna match these pixels with the RGB mask and create a simple mask. Okay, so for each individual RGB mask, okay so for each individual color we're gonna match it against the RGB mask, and we're gonna create a map called C map. So this is basically a binary mask for this class. So basically for each individual class, like first it would start background, so it would create for a binary mask for background, then aeroplane, then bicycle. So like this we would have individual mask for individual classes. So what we're gonna do here, we're gonna append these individual masks in this list. Okay, so now this output mask contain all the individual binary mask. Okay, and now we know that at one place only one class would exist, either it would be 1, 2, 3, 4 or either 20, 19, any class. So that's why it easy for us to do it this way only, create individual binary mask. So if I let me just show you the these individual binary mask also. Let me just write the simple function in, so you're going to save them in mask only. So we have created this mask directory here, and we're going to say I dot png. Okay, and let's say cmap into 255. So these cmap basically contain values between 0 and 1. So I'm going to multiply it with 255. So 0 remains 0 and 1 became 255, basically white color. So let's run it, and we're going to look at the mask class. So you can see 20 classes. Okay, 21 classes. One is background. So you can see this is background class. So you can see individual binary mask is there. The classes which does not exist does not contain anything. So we are going to combine all these masks. So we have combined all these masks into one single basically mask. Next we're going to stack these output masks. On the last axis, then we're going to return this mask. So this is done. So this is the simple function which you need to understand, just this function and everything is done. Okay, you need not to check any other function. This is the main function which you need in this entire video. So if you are happier with this, you can exit the video. If you want to see the complete thing, now this mask is in a one hot encoding form. Let me just show you the shape of this process mask. So from my prediction, this processed mask, let me just give you the shape, like my prediction, 320 by 320 by the number of class, and these are 21 classes. So this should be the shape. Okay, so you can see 320 by 320 by 21. So this is basically one hot vector mask. Okay, it contain values only the 0 and 1 pixels. Okay, now how to convert, you can even convert it into grayscale. Like if you don't need like one hot vector, you need a grayscale mask, like not a grayscale, we can call it single channel mask. Basically it contain values like 0, 1, 2, 3 till 21. Okay, till 20 basically, 0 to 20, 21 classes. So you can also do that very easily. What you can do, we're going to say grayscale mask, we're going to now call it grayscale, let's call it grayscale because grayscale is one channel mask. So this grayscale mask, we're gonna do arg max over the last axis. Now what we can do, okay? So these grayscale masks basically contain values between 0 to 20. Let me just show you these. Okay. So let us print this value. So you can see it contains 7 classes starting from 0 to 7. As we've already seen, okay, I have already deleted those binary masks. So in those binary masks, if you remember, we don't have every mask as binary. We have multiple masks as black, which basically mean these class does not exist. Only 7 class exist here. Okay, so that's why only 7. Let me just remove this break statement from here, and we're going to see some more. You can see it does not contain many extra classes, just some contain 7, some contain 8, and some contain only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 classes. So you can see, as I have only used 5 images and mask, you can use the entire data set or any other data set. Just make sure that this every time I'm telling that, make sure that this color map is accurate, and do check out this whether what I have written is correct or not. Okay. Okay, so now we have this mask. What we gonna do? Like, these pixels are between 0 to 20. We assume this is the number of classes. Now let's save these images, okay, and see what it look like. So we're gonna expand its dimension, okay, and we're gonna write some lines of code here. Let me just copy paste them, paste them. Okay, so here what we're gonna do, okay, let me just paste this one last line also. Okay, so here we have this array called line, which is of the height 320, width 5, and 3 channels. Basically we have multiplied 250, so it's a white line. Now we have this variable called cat images, and here we concatenate all the images. First is image, the original RGB image, then the original RGB mask, and then the grayscale mask. Okay, and we are saving it. Now let's see how it looks. Let me remove this break statement. So let's run it. Okay, so all the 5 masks are like processed. Okay, so if you can see, I don't know whether you are able to see this, the last part. You can see we have the RGB mask, then RGB mask, and here at last, if you see, we have this slightly grayish image. Okay, like now these pixels are in the range of 0 to 20. You can even convert them in the range of 0 to 255. Just add this simple line here. Okay, between these two lines, just add the simple line. Just divide the grayscale mask with the number of classes and then multiply it with 255. Okay, now you're gonna see much more highlighted view. Okay, I think now we can easily see much more highlighted view. But now these are not between 0 to 20. These are between 0 to 255. So it's up to you whether you need one hot encoding mask. So this is one hot encoded mask. And at last, here we have the mask with the single channel mask. So it's up to you what kind of mask you require. So this is all about, this is about this entire video, just to show you how can you take this RGB mask and convert it into a single channel or one hot encoded mask, okay, which you usually require in multi-class segmentation. In case of binary segmentation, is really easy. Read the image as grayscale and then divide by 255. So I hope I was able to give you some new information through this video, and if you really enjoyed it, do check out the channel and like this video. Thank you and have a nice day.